Okay, everyone, welcome back to the channel. So glad you could come over and check out another video. Anyhow, so today's ride, as you can see, I'm on the FX350 again. And as a reminder, or in case you're new and are unaware, this is a 2023 FX350. And today I'm up in the mountains. Yeah, that's right. We finally have broken free of the snow and the trails have been open to us to start shredding up in the mountains again. And oh my, this is one of my favorite trails in this area. And I was so excited to get up here and get the 350 up in the mountains to see what it was like on tight single track. And it did not. Let me tell you. That being said, I do have some pretty crazy news for anyone that's been following my channel for the last few months. Early on, I had a 2020 300XC and I was comparing the two bikes back to back, trying to determine which of the two I thought was the most fun. And winner of that competition was the FX350, and that's still the case between those two bikes. This is definitely the more fun bike. You know, as far as four strokes go, these 350s, and I shouldn't say all of them, and I'm not going to say they all are, because I've rode some of the previous generation 350s, so everything prior to 2023, and to me, those bikes were kind of boring to ride. They're good bikes, but I just didn't really gel with them that much, and so I was a little nervous when I bought this one, but I had read so many rave reviews, I decided to give it a shot and see what these were all about, and I'm not sorry that I did it. Just a phenomenal bike. The power to weight ratio is really just something that you gotta try it to understand it. I think, at least for me, I don't know how I would ever put it into words, but nonetheless, just a fantastic bike, and it did a great job up here in the mountains. Would I say that it's on par with a two-stroke up here in this mountainous single track? Well, no, I would say the two-stroke still has the edge for this type of riding, but, you know, there's a give and take with everything. Anyhow, that being said, I do have some big news. There is a big change that took place a couple of days after this ride, and I'm not going to share what that change is. You'll have to come back to my channel and find out in my next video. Needless to say, this is the final ride of the FX350. That being said, I'm not saying I made this change because the bike unsatisfactory, because that would be an outright lie. These 350s are a blast. They are fantastic. And if you live in an area where it's really open, man, these are really hard to beat. I actually still think for an overall race bike, especially here in Utah, where a lot of the races, all of the races take place out in the deserts, so much more open area, the FX350 is the cat's meow. This is definitely the bike to own for that type of riding. I'm not a racer. I have raced, and I've done fairly well in the past, but I don't find that I like spending the money on race events. They're kind of pricey, and The reality is I can just ride the same areas for free. So why spend $100? Anyhow, I'm going to stop rambling and let you guys just finish watching this video. It was an incredible ride. Had a great time. And I'll catch you in my next video. Hope you come back later. Or should I say, keep the tires down and keep playing the dirt.
Dry line. Bad.